Hello, how the YouTube algorithm, the YouTube age and the YouTube video creation process. Hello, how creating videos makes everyone's opportunities, at least on YouTube, a little more equal. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Oliver. I run 4 KFC restaurants in Switzerland and I'm a volunteering fireman. When we talk about YouTube and the opportunities there, there's a wonderful mechanism, or let's say part of equality inside of it. And I think that everyone who has a smartphone or some sort of camera and internet access, which luckily nowadays is part of many people's or almost all people's lives, can create YouTube videos, can create content, and you never know what will happen out of that. So in my case right now, I'm recording this video on a smartphone. It's an iPhone 11 because it fits better to my video mic Mi L from Rode. And yes, I will leave links in the description because I think with a lightning adapter, this microphone is the best thing you can do for mobile vlogging style video creation with your iPhone. You will tell me in the comments how you think the sound is, but I personally, out of experience now, say it's pretty amazing. So I'm walking outside now and I can make this video so you can too. So it means everyone who has this kind of opportunities can record a video. And if you buy that microphone, you have the better audio. But that's the only benefit this microphone is giving you. To create content, you just need something to record and something to upload. So in the past, that was not possible. You needed a studio, you needed a proper camera, which would probably cost more money than any given smartphone nowadays. And you don't even have the internet when I was younger. So this now is really giving opportunities for so many people. And I still think that though the quantity goes over quality, but at the end, someone's common knowledge might be another one's treasure. And the treasure sometimes is not the treasure you're looking for. I mean, if I give you rubies, but you like sapphires, it's the wrong gem, you know? But you'll never know when you create the content who is looking for it. So at first, I suggest everyone to start with just creating content. And I think this is, everyone can do that. I mean, even, and now please forgive me the example. I never knew how to make a football out of nothing, basically. But if you learned in your childhood, because you had no other opportunities, to wire a football out of leaves and branches from trees, I mean, why not make a video on that? If you had to put baskets together in your childhood to survive, I mean, it's not that I'm saying here, yeah, that's a good thing. No, I would love that everyone can go to school when he's younger instead of having to work in young age to make the family survive. But if you learned that in the past, you can make a video on it. It doesn't mean you have to. But there's so many small wisdoms out there which are unseen if not created. And coming back, everyone can do so. And I feel that sometimes the hands-on experiences you made in your life are more valuable than all the stuff you learn at school, especially if you want to recreate it on a video, because the school stuff is traded and just being placed into encyclopedias, etc. But the hands-on stuff sometimes has to be shown. And by having the opportunities to show it to everyone, or anyone who's looking for it, I think that's magic. And this is something we sometimes forget about, even in our normal business concepts where we learn something, where we made a training, an apprenticeship, or went to some sort of school, that we forgot that at the end we're gonna be hired also for our personality, for being ourselves, for being someone who contributes not just by hard facts and skills, but also by personality and enthusiasm, etc. So what does it mean that also if you're in a creative business, if you are in a business of offering your skills to someone else in hard facts, if you're able to do something like this and you even enjoy doing it, then even better, why not place it into the public? And I saw an example on LinkedIn that someone was applying for a carpenter job, and he created the folder where the application was placed inside out of wood with a hinge and all that stuff. So the creation process would be a nice video, the final result would be a nice video, and the result itself as a creative process spoke for itself. For every other thing where we want to show people what we do as a volunteering part in our life, when we do help other companies, when we do help other organizations, when we do something for the church, same as like Sean Cannell, who made videos for the church he's part of, all this can help you later on. Could it be in your negative? Actually, I feel it should not. And if it is the case, maybe if you do the content in an honest and correct way and not being like hating or offending in the classical terms, then it should be always beneficial for you. Will there be people who don't like this kind of putting yourself out there? For sure there are. And if that's the case, I would probably say it's an easy decision that are not the people you want to work with from the mindset. There have been for sure scenarios like banks, insurances, who have to be more critical with what is perceivable outside, but still you are a human being and you can do for yourself what you want to do. And you selectively choose what you want to share explicitly with an employer or explicitly with a client or a company you want to work with, etc. That's just my take. Limitations are there. I mean, even I am falling under some constraints. There's YouTube's algorithm, which gives you some topics where you have to be careful about. But overall, wherever you are, you can create, you can go out there. And if you see right now, in like, even probably in Western cultures where you have like limitations due to job policies, etc., you might be even more limited in creating videos than if you're not in the kind of world where those topics are relevant for you. Therefore, get yourself out there. Get yourself in front of the phones, in front of the camera, and create. Share your knowledge, share your experiences, share the things so others can learn, probably even from your mistakes, or even better, learn from your best practices so they can apply it right away and have basically a shortcut in their life. I hope that helps. If you have any opinions and thoughts on this, leave it down in the comment section. And that's all from my side. Have a great one.